We're hands-on with Chrome's latest AI features. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian, and as we dive into today's AI features, please keep in mind how important it is to keep Google Chrome up to date. With that, here are all the Google Chrome AI updates for 2025 so far. So far being a major hint for big things coming soon. First up, there's a new way for you to search what you see with Google Lens in Chrome. I just love this. All right, let's say you've come across an article and you need to know what shoe SJP is rocking in this image. Don't panic if you don't see a Google Lens option. All you're gonna do is click on the address bar, and the Google Lens option should appear for you right in your address bar. And by the way, if this is a really long URL, it may just look like a camera icon. So we're gonna click on the Google Lens option, and then we'll simply use our mouse to drag over the item that we want more information on. This might be tricky, but let's see how Lens does for us with these shoes. Okay, here on the right, it's pulled some very similar looking shoes. So these don't appear to be the exact versions, but it's quite close, which is awesome. And you can also pin the Google Lens option to your toolbar for even quicker access. All you're gonna do is simply click the pin option near the top right. If you don't see any of this, as in there's no lens option in your address bar, you can click on that three-dot menu icon in the top right of your Chrome and then select Search with Google Lens. If you want an entire video on how to use Google Lens in Chrome, including how to refine your search, which is really helpful, use it on mobile, or search using your camera, you can watch an entire tutorial by clicking up here or via the link in the description below. The next Google Chrome AI update allows you to rediscover your search history in a more conversational tone. This is good because how many times have you visited a site and then forgot what the site was, but you hadn't saved it, and now you want to go back to it, but you don't even know how you got there or what the site was? Well, now you can just ask Chrome. Here's what I mean. From Chrome, we're going to click the three-dot menu icon and head to our settings. And here on the left, click on AI Innovations. Underneath AI Innovation, we want to click on History Search Powered by AI. And right up at the top, let's toggle on the history search powered by AI. This is gonna let us search our history in a more conversational tone. So Google tells us here that this is a new feature and it's still in development, so it might not always get it right, and that AI powered history search results might be outdated if the site's changed and the like. But with this toggled on, all that's left to do is head to our search history and ask Chrome for what we need. Head to that three-dot menu icon on the top right of Chrome and hover over History and then click on History. Right now at the top, because we've toggled that on, we can see it's now asking us to search our history using a few words. And we've got a Get Answers from Your History powered by AI since we've toggled that on. So I'm gonna keep this simple and just search like Sarah Jessica Parker. And look at that. This was the article I forgot to bookmark. And just like that, we can click on it to open the webpage back up. Now it's worth noting here that I did have some mixed results with this. Sometimes it worked and sometimes it simply did not. But as this improves, you can imagine searching for things like, what was that gelato shop I looked at? Or what was the best MagSafe charger I found the other day? And so on. By the way, there are a ton of other cool Google Chrome AI features and I've linked to them in the description below. So you'll definitely wanna check those out so you make sure you're getting the most out of your Google Chrome browsing experience. The next new Chrome AI feature is to compare products across different sites with Tab Compare. This is going to be really helpful for your online shopping. And as of right now, I do not have access to this yet, but I'm going to show you how it should work. And then if you can comment below and let me know if you have access to this yet, that would be great. So from Chrome, head back to your settings using that three-dot menu icon. And from here, ensure you turn on Sync. Then under the Sync and Google Services, you should have automatically that Make Searches and Browsing Better toggled on for you. Now, when Tab Compare is working properly, you'll have to have all the tabs open with the item it is that you want to compare. So for this example, you can see that I have three tabs open and I'm switching back and forth between them, comparing different versions of a portable speaker. Okay, so if this is working properly for you, you should have an option appear next to your tab, somewhere up here, asking you if you want to generate a comparison. So from there, you would click on yes, that you want to generate the comparison. Obviously, since I don't have this option yet, let's switch over to what Google says this is going to look like for you. This is gonna open up a new tab. That's the compare tab. And that's gonna compare all the products using the product specs, features, price ratings, and more. It's gonna be all in one spot where you'll be able to easily compare without having to switch back and forth between tabs all the time. So keep in mind that tab compare is AI generated, and it is only available to start for users in the US over age 18. And as I said, I still don't have access to it yet, so I guess I just have to be a little more patient. But essentially, Tab Compare should present you an AI generated comparison of all of the products, up to 10, that you want to compare in one central space. Let's hope we all have access to it soon. So now I want to hear from you. Do you have these Chrome AI features yet, and do you love them? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Chrome videos. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.